Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy. I want to finish the lecture on accuracy, precision, and greatest possible error. It's easy to get confused between accuracy and precision. Remember, accuracy is how close the measured value is to the actual true value. If you're exactly right, then that's very accurate. Precise just has to do with the precision of your instrument. How precise can you even be? So let's take a look at these four things that I have up here. These are tape measures or pictures of tape measures. You may not be able to read this, but I think I can talk you through it. This is between 1 inch and 2 inch on a tape measure. Halfway would be 1/2. And again, you may not be able to read that. But this is marked off in 16ths, 1/16, 2/16, 3/16, 4/16. 4/16 is the same as 1/4. 5/16, 6/7, 8/16 is 1/2. And finally, 15/16 over here is 1. So we know that we want to know how precise is this. Well, if you're going to use this instrument, you can be precise to the 1/16, right? 1/16, this is as precise as you can get. Take a look at this ruler down here. This ruler has 1/2 inches and 1/4 inches. If I was to measure something with this, the most precise I could get would be to the 1/4, right? That's as precise as we get. The smallest measurement we have is 1/4 of an inch. That's all the precision I could give you with that. This one, I could give you something to the 1/16. And in the auto shops, they use tape measures regularly that go to the 1/64. Or in machine shops, when they're being very accurate, they'll have things that have actually out to the 1/64. What about this one down here? Well, if you count the numbers in between, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, that means that this one is actually to the 1/8 of an inch. The 1/8 is the most precise we could be there. This is actually a meter stick. There's 100 millimeters in 1 meter. So when you look at a meter stick, it's about 3 feet long. It's about 39 inches long, actually. I just had the end of it here. So each of these marks represents centimeters. So there's actually 100 centimeters in 1 meter. And then each centimeter is broke down into 10 parts so that there's 10 for every 1 centimeter. So that's 10 times 100 or 1,000 millimeters in an entire meter. So this is precise to the millimeters. That's the most precise you can be. And maybe if you saw something was right in here, maybe but just between two, we might want to say, oh, that's, you know, 970, and then we could count. But we really can't say if it's halfway in between. We don't really know. We can't be any more precise than the tool that we're using. That's my point. And also, I did some reading about tape measures in general, and they're not very accurate if you just go buy one at the department store or something, but you can buy a precision tape measure. And what I read was that for a 12-foot precision tape measure, it will be accurate to plus or minus 1/32nd of an inch. So you can be sure that if you measure it, you're within 1/32nd, right? So that's not too bad. If it's beyond 12 feet, if it's longer than 12 feet, then it's precise to within 1/16th of an inch, which is the smaller fraction. 1/32nd is the smaller fraction because it has the greater denominator and the numerators are both 1. So this is the greater fraction. So I'm sorry, this is the greater fraction. This is the lesser fraction. So we have less mistakes. We're less accurate here because we have a bigger mistake. We're more accurate here because we have a smaller possible mistake. Remember, accuracy is how close we are to the actual measured value. So when you're looking at a tape, choosing your instrument to use, your tape measure to use or whatever, you want to think about how precise do you need to be. If someone told you that a stick was 15.5 inches long, what is the instrument from above that was did they use? Which one of those did they use? Well, they didn't use this one because this is metric. Which one of those, if it was 15.5? Well, you can't really tell because this has 1/2, this has 1/2, and this one has 1/2. This one they might have got exactly 1/2. This one they might have gotten 4/8 and reduced it to 1/2. This one they might have gotten 8/16 and reduced it to 1/2. You can't really tell how precise the instrument was when you're given a measurement like 15.5. Since you can't tell the answer, you have to assume that the precision was 1/2. You have to assume they were using an instrument with 1/2 because you don't know anymore, and you can't assume something to be more precise. So you just have to make that. All right. So we're going to talk about greatest possible error and then come back to this. Let's look at these tachometers. We talked about tachometers before, and most of you are probably familiar with these. All of these dials, it's a little different. Each one's a little different. And these maybe aren't that easy for you to see either. I could try turning on a light, but usually when I turn the lamp on, it makes things worse. Let's see what happens here. I could turn a lamp on. Is that better? I think it is. Okay, so this one you can see is just barely past the 40 mark. You can't maybe see. They have them blown up above, so that's what you can see. It's just above, past the 40. This one's the one that's barely past the 40. And this one over here is, you can see that all three of these are close, but they're all a little different. This was the 43 mark you're seeing here, right? So they all look a little different, but you would read all of those as 4100. Notice this is the 4100 mark, and this one's a little above it. This one's a little below it. This one's pretty much on it, but they would all be read as that. In fact, if somebody told you that there was 4,100 RPMs, you wouldn't really know. And by the way, these are hundreds and not thousands. That's why I'm saying hundreds on these. In fact, the RPM is anywhere between 4,050 and 4,150. Anything between there, we would say, is about 4,100. 4,100 would be the most precise measurement we could get using this tachometer because it's marked off in hundreds, okay? And so we can't go any more precise than that because we don't know. We can only be as precise as the instrument that we're using. That's what I want to say. We could assume that if this was three different readings that they look like they're pretty precise, we don't really know how accurate they are. We don't know what the actual thing was, and we feel pretty good about it. So the other thing in these lectures that's important to talk about is the greatest possible error. So how much possible error could we have if we were using the tachometers shown above? It's always equal to 1/2 of the instrument's precision. So this precision goes to the 100. So with the most precision we would have here is, we would say the greatest possible error is 50, because we would take the precision of the instrument, divide by 2, and that would tell us this tachometer, greatest possible error is 50. You could be 50 below or 50 above, and it would still look like that. So we wanted to calculate the greatest possible error for the figures at the beginning of the document. So let's go back to these nice shapes or nice pictures that I had and figure out what's the precision. Well, what's the precision of this? Well, it was 1/16, and we are going to divide that by 2. Remember, when you divide something by 2, you actually are multiplying by 2 over 1, right? When you divide by 2, you're actually, you have to flip that first second fraction. When you're dividing by 2, you flip or find the reciprocal of the second one. It's not, yeah, so that's what I went to do. I have to flip that second one, and I change the division to multiplication. And that means the greatest possible error, I'm just going to say GPE, the greatest possible error when you're working with 1/16 is 1/32. You're doubling that, because it's a fraction. Okay. What's the greatest possible error for when you have eighths? Well, when you have eighths and you divide by 2, you actually, again, multiply by 1/2. And it's 1/16 is your greatest possible error. Notice all we're doing is doubling the denominator to find the greatest possible error when we're working with fractions. What about if it was 1/2? 1/2 divided by 2 is 1/2 times 1 over 2, or 1/4. So it's easy with fractions. You're just going to double the denominator to find that greatest possible error. Here the precision was to the millimeter, 1 millimeter. 1 divided by 2 is 0.5. We could leave it as fractions if we wanted. We could say 1 times 1 over 2 if we wanted, like we did the other ones, and say it's 1/2 or 0.5. It's half of a millimeter, because it's half, 1 millimeter cut in half is a half, right? We could say 0.5 or 1/2. So the precision has to do with how precise are the markings on your measure or your tool. And then the greatest possible error is whatever that is divided by 2. And it just is times 1/2 if you're working with fractions. When more precision is called for, you use a more precise instrument. That's why I was talking about tape measures that are more precise. Maybe you need a tape measure that shows up to the 64th inches. And of course, now you have the luxury of using instruments that are digital. But they used to use things like, and I don't know how to pronounce that, vernier, I think, calipers, look like this. And this is what they used to use. They had for external measurements and internal measurements and depth measurements. And it all had this really precise empirical scale, is the scale we use, like the English numbers. And then we have the metric scale down here. And so you have this whole system here that you could use to get precise measurements. And maybe you've seen those in the shop or something where you work. I'm not sure if you see them or not, but that's what people used to have to use before digital came along. You might have seen a micrometer, which is a more precise way to measure things than just a ruler. You put your object inside here to figure out the width of it. That's a really nice, if you have a ball or something that's round, it's hard to use a ruler to measure that, right? So you can put that inside there and measure that with a micrometer. It has these different parts to it. When you do your activity in class, we'll have to look at precision and accuracy and greatest possible error using different shapes. And the thing is, now when I talk to the people, the instructors in the different departments, there's a lot of digitized measuring tools now, so you won't have to do too many. But just keep in mind accuracy, precision, and greatest common error, and you use significant digits in that process. All right, have a fantastic day. I'll talk to you next time.